Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Nova Spirit Tech, and today we are going to be adding button trigger activation on our Google Assistant. So let's get started. All right, so we're going to need a button, an LED, resistors, some wires, and I managed to find this button that has everything, the ring light in there and a momentary switch, which I'll leave a link in the description below. Now for the Raspberry Pi, it has ground, gpio 18, which is for the button, then ground again, then gpio 23 for the LED. So guys, now that we're in the coding part, I assume that you guys followed my tutorial on installing Google Assistant on the Raspberry Pi. If not, I'll leave a link in the description and a card up above. All right, to start off, we're gonna have to jump into our environment. So what we're gonna do is source environment bin activate. Now we have to actually install the Raspberry Pi GPIO. It's going to be pip install r capital R p lowercase I dot GPIO capital GPIO. I already have it installed, but you're just going to go through this setup and, you know, take a few minutes. All right, now that we're done with that, we're going to have to edit our Google sample file. So we're going to do Genie, which is an editor that is already in Raspberry Pi. It's actually a really good editor for coding. And we're going to go into env lib python 3.4/site packages google samples, and then there's something called assistant in there, and then we're going to edit the file called 2_main2_.py. All right, once we're in that file, first thing we need to do is actually import our new Raspberry Pi GPIOs. So import capital RP lowercase I dot GPIO. Now instead of constantly typing that, we're actually going to name it as GPIO, so it's much easier. I'm going to go down a couple of lines past the imports and stuff like that, and we're going to set up our GPIO pins for our button and the GPIO pin for our LED. So first, let's set up the board. It's going to be gpio.setMode, and we're going to set the mode to gpio.bcm, and that's all capital. Now we're going to set our GPIO pins for the button, so it's going to be gpio.setup18, which is the pin we're using, gpio.in pull up down equals gpio dot pud underscore up, and then close that parentheses. Now we're going to set up our LED, so gpio dot setup, and we put that into 23, and we're going to turn that into gpio out so we can send voltage out on that. Now once we set up all the appropriate pins that we need, we're going to scroll all the way down to about 197, I think. And right here is actually where the code starts, while true, and basically everything loops. And if wait for trigger, and you guys probably know what this is, click pause, press enter to send a new request. So what we're going to do is comment that out, because we're not going to do that. Now, if you left it like this, basically it's just going to constantly listen for your command, so you don't even have to press a button. But we're going to be adding a trigger now. All right, now we're going to add our commands. Now, one thing you have to keep in mind is how everything is tabbed. Python works by tab, the indents, and it's very specific. So if the whole project indented by spaces like this project did, you have to follow that method. And every time if I hit enter, look, it just automatically make tabs, and that's going to ruin the project. So what we need to do is actually space everything out. And for Google, they were using 4 spaces per indent, so you basically need 12 spaces over here. Now, we can start off with input state. We're going to call this variable input state. And it's basically going to be GPIO input 18. So it's basically going to read what GPIO pin is going to be doing. Now, if input state equals 2 equals true, which means if it actually is not pressed, it's actually a little bit backwards, but if it's not pressed or if it's true, this is what we're going to do. Turn off the LED. GPIO dot output 23 false, and then we're gonna do continue. This will basically roll back up to the while statement, so it won't continue with the script. Now just make sure this is all spaced out, and we're gonna go back to this space over here and put in else. See how I'm doing that? Else, and we're gonna do gpio dot output 23 true. Now this is gonna turn on the LED, and we're gonna do pass, and that will continue the script on. So basically what we got over here is we're gonna read the state of our button, and with that state we're gonna see if it's true. If it's true, then we will actually restart the project and turn off the LED. We won't continue with it, or you know, or else we will detect that it is being pressed. We will turn on the LED and pass the command and continue on with the rest. So once you hit save, we can close this out because we don't need this anymore. Now we could do python-m Google samples dot assistant, and the button should be working. What is the weather like in New York?
In New York City, it's 48 and mostly cloudy. It'll be partly cloudy, with a forecasted high of 58 and a low of 46.
Tell me a joke.
This might make you laugh. What's Forrest Gump's password? 1 Forrest 1.
So, thanks for watching my video. If you guys liked this video, please hit that thumbs up. If you guys have any questions about this, hit in the comments below or hit me up on Twitter, because I've been actually very active on Twitter recently. Now, I actually recommend using a trigger activation versus a voice activation, which I do have in the works. I actually got that all completed, but I am working on cleaning up the code and stuff like that for you guys. Stay tuned for that video if you want voice activation for Google Assistant. If you guys haven't done so already, hit this little circle to subscribe to my channel, or watch these other videos that I've made all by myself. As I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.